Minnesota Vikings select Anthony Barr, linebacker.
Anthony Barr will record the sack.
Davin Cook, running back, Florida State.
Dalvin. And he blows!
Minnesota select Justin Jefferson.
Welcome back here inside the TCO studios. The 2021 first round of the NFL draft has concluded, and the Minnesota Vikings have selected Christian Darrisaw, offensive tackle from Virginia Tech, with the 23rd overall selection. I got Ron Johnson from Vikings Game Day Live, Vikings team reporter Eric Smith, and guys, I want to get your thoughts starting with Ron. When you hear a guy like Mike Zimmer say, we need to add size to the offensive line, and then you see Rick Spielman select Christian Darrisaw, 6'5", 322 pounds. What's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Well, long arms, but they got their guy. I think that's the key, is we all said offensive line. We didn't know if it was going to be a guard or a tackle. Vera Tucker went off the board. When the trades went back, everybody was saying it could be a defensive guy. But offensive line, even though Spielman kind of said, well, this is a thought, and then Zimmer laughed, you know, when people asked him, did you have to take offensive guard or tackle? Mm-hmm. They had to, but they didn't want to say it. So I think the key is you got the guy you wanted, but you got him at a lower rate, and that's the key. You pay him less, and you got some draft capital, like Rick said, to get back in the second round. So it's perfect.
Yeah, so speaking of getting back into the second round, possibly the Vikings traded with the Jets, the 14th overall pick for the 23rd overall pick. In return, the Vikings got two third-round picks, 66 and 86. But Eric, when you see a guy like Christian Darrisaw that fell to the Vikings where they wanted him to, how does he fit within our offensive scheme?
He fits perfect, and that's exactly what the Vikings were trying to do. So Darrisaw ran this wide zone run scheme at Virginia Tech, and so he's going to fit in perfectly with the Vikings, presumably at left tackle. You know, Rick Spielman called Darrisaw a pure left tackle, and to me that says day one he's going to be there at the starting left tackle spot. We know that Garrett Bradbury will be the center, and that now Ezra Cleveland will probably stay at right guard, and Brian O'Neill will be at right tackle. So four of the five spots to me are set. We'll see what happens at left guard. But like you said, Gabe, with four third-round picks on Friday, there's certainly a lot of draft capital to make a move there too.
Four third-round picks, three fourth-round picks on day three. There's still not a second-round pick, but we know Trader Rick is a real thing. So looking to day two, Ron, like, is the number one priority of trading back to the second round, or are you sticking with 66, which is – I think the second pick in the third round, which is still kind of an early pick.
When you look at the second round picks that the Vikings have had, you got Dalvin Cook, you got Ezra Cleveland, you got Brian O'Neill. So when you look at the value in the second round, I say you go do it. There's still some guys out there that have not been drafted that can play on this team. And so when you look at the guard from Michigan, you look at the other guard from Alabama that played, you know, next to Leatherwood, those are the guys that could be great picks, value picks in the second round. And you have enough third and fourth rounds to add depth. We know they're going to need linebacker depth. They're going to need some corner safety, or definitely safety depth. And I like that opportunity. And then you still have Jamar Johnson. If you can get in the second round and get a guy like Rondale Moore, kick returner, punt returner, explosive, that's going to be the way to go. And so I'm excited. But like Eric said, the way Darrisaw fits is because he ran this scheme. The one thing he's going to have to learn when you double team is stick with it. In college, he's been known to leave a little early to go pancake somebody else. Mm-hmm. He's going to have to learn that here.
Well, he's learning from some of the best coaches in Phil Rauscher and Rick Dennison. And Eric, you talk about a guy like Christian Darrisaw. We got our offensive tackle. We got that need out of the way. What other needs do this Vikings team have to address in day two?
Yeah, Ron mentioned a few at corner. You know, it could be a possibility. Safety, a position I'm going to have my eye on tomorrow is defensive end. That was projected a lot in a lot of pre-draft mock drafts. The Vikings could have taken a defensive end at 14. To have four third-round picks, like Ron said, to potentially trade back up, someone like maybe Ronnie Perkins out of Oklahoma, Basham, I think, out of Wake Forest. I know Peyton Turner went in the first round. That was a little higher than I was expecting, but he was a candidate too. So defensive end could be a guy. And you know Mike Zimmer is going to want to focus on his defense after getting an offensive lineman now. He Zim's going to be back pounding the table to help out on defense.
Well, the Vikings have four picks tomorrow, all of those in the third round. Right now they still have, I think, 11 more picks left in the NFL draft, so we will see what they do. Tomorrow is a big day. Day two is coming sooner than we think, so Vikings fans, stay tuned to Vikings.com and all of our social media channels for the most up-to-date coverage of the team.